Okay. Recording. So, gloves on. Antibiotic. Water for flushing. Water for mixing. Okay. What I've got to do first, take that off. Open this up. On the side, and then open this bad boy up before. Right, clean. Inspect it for any bubbly wobblies. No bubbly wobblies in there. So take the end off. Get the end. Good old clean. Put it on there. This thing is trying to get the bloody needles out. This is such a pain in the ass. Surely they couldn't give me some tablets to do this. That's two. Let's just swing this around a little bit there. Don't waste any helicopter, a whole lot of. Right. Tap it to get any of those. Stubbing that lab up is out. Infusion. has air bubbles on. Oh, poor little man. Okay. Keeping that clean. Now, the mixing of the drug. Too much about the air on this one because I've been injecting it into that little bottle to mix it. See, the other one is sodium chloride, or contains sodium chloride. It's commonly known as saline solution. This is actual water for injection. Ooh, shut it all over the place. That's good, isn't it? Grab on that. Oh God, it sounds like an elephant's up there. So now the water for injection goes into the Ceftriaxone. Now, we just gotta wait for this to go clear. Actually, that's quite quickly, actually. I'm quite amazed at this stuff. And gotta get it home. pain. Now, pull out one of these, just checking again that the air bubbles haven't returned. Stick it in there.
Love you.
And then using a push-pause method, we just gently push it in, and I can feel it going in, and it just feels so cool. It really does feel sort of like nice and refreshing as it goes through your arm. It's weird. I'll tell you what then, I was scared about having this PICC line in when they first told me I had to have it in. Because obviously it goes from my arm, which is there, and it's about 550 millimetres long, so it goes all the way down here somewhere. Gets into your veins a little bit quicker. Obviously they put it in a vein and not in an artery, because if they put it in an artery it will blow it straight back out and there'll be blood everywhere. But obviously veins return to the heart and arteries come out of them. So there's a lot more blood pressure coming out of the heart than there is going back in. So that's why you've got the systolic and diastolic in a, on your blood pressure meters. Oh, who's letting themselves in the door now? Okay. Anyway, so now we've completed the infusion, chuck away that syringe, or you check the time. Right, it's nearly. So, let's stick our drugs in. I'm using the same method. We start pushing that through. Obviously we've got to use it at a lower pressure, because if we go and just ram it in, it's just going to blow the PICC line out. So I'm roughly looking at about a milliliter in just under a minute for this whole vial. 2 millimeters per minute, sorry, got my maths wrong. This is the boring bit. Do you reckon you could do this, really?
No.
I reckon you can, you see, because it's so dead simple. There's nothing to sort of like freak out about now. Yeah. I feel this is better than having a cannula in. Although this is a cannula of sorts, but you got somebody to help you. Done about 6 mils so far. Doesn't matter if you're slightly faster. The trick is not blowing anything out of this line. I'm just going with what is kind of feeling good.
Hello.
Hello, sweetie.
Oh, sorry.
Cats. No one in on the show. Oi, not yet. Save some for later on when the guests arrive. necessity. Probing time.
I've got longer fingers.
Well, that's not hard to beat.
Want acrylics then?
Get a nice frame for that and put it up somewhere.
Done this time next year.
And then you've got my baby Yoda to do.
I have that in my drink.
I don't know. Something that you left it out there.
Yes.
Right, we're just about coming up to the end of the infusion. Well, the administration of the drugs bit, anyway. We've got our last little millimetre to go. And that's that.
Hello. Yeah. Oh, hello, darling.
The flush is to just clear the lines once the drug is administered, make sure everything is nice and clear, and this will stop it from sort of like, you know, getting clogged up and having to go in and have it pulled out and re-administered, which I wouldn't look forward to. Does it itch like hell around the side where it goes in, because I've had to make a nice little incision in my arm and put this anchoring device on. And where the friggin' hell did that bubble come from? Through nicely. There we go, and that is it done for today. Give me a wipe. Okay, good clean. Worst part, the fiddly part, is trying to get it back in where you can hold it so like in a nice comfortable place so as it's not dangling and all sorts in you. So I've got till Tuesday when they come and do the PICC line dressing. I get all the stuff done at Addenbrokes, so nice little trip into Cambridge every week. Not too bad, at least I'm not going to London working. Right, that's it.